There is a campaign by what appears to be mostly middle-aged and elderly middle-class left-wingers to close the Bibby Stockholm barge. They say it's like a prison ship, that it's inhumane, and human beings shouldn't be forced to live in those conditions. These include people like the Portland Global Friendship Group. Now, they have a link to the website freemovement.org.uk on their Facebook page, and they work very closely with immigration barristers who many people believe are little more than activists in a wig. You've got Stand Up To Racism Dorset and the usual bunch at Care For Calais. They're all piping up, OK? Well, GB News has come into possession of videos that appear to be taken by asylum seekers on the barge. Now, remember, this is the supposedly inhumane floating prison that we're talking about here. As you can see, there appears to be quite a happy bunch of young men dancing, playing pool and relaxing. Now, obviously, the experience is different for everyone, but they seem in good spirits there. You can see that is the inside of the Bibby Stockholm because there were videos taken from inside it before it opened. There is also a place where they can watch films and they can drink cans of Red Bull as well. Yeah, I mean, this looks a lot like the video room previously advertised on the ship, doesn't it? So there they are. This is a taxpayer-funded bus service as well that allows the Bibby Stockholm residents to go into the town. Now, on the same Snapchat account that posted the previous videos, all right, there is also this video recording. The video itself appears to show the inside of a gun and knife shop around the Weymouth area. Now, we know that that shop exists and that it is in the vicinity near the Bibby Stockholm barge, but we cannot verify whether that video was taken by someone who's living on the Bibby Stockholm barge. It was simply posted on the same Snapchat account. Well, none of this seems particularly inhumane or prison-like, does it? Especially not that last video. Another video on that account appears to have been taken from inside a cocktail bar. Now, it may be that that video was taken by an individual before he was moved to the Bibby Stockholm. But again, it does beg the question, doesn't it? Are asylum seekers really treated as badly as these middle-class, middle-aged human rights warriors like to believe? Portland Global Friendship Group organise events as well like this with Bibby residents. This is this woodland adventure that they've got, all right? There is a medical facility on the barge as well, which is available. Our Home and Security Editor Mark White went onto the barge and was impressed by the facilities. It had all previously been used to house people like oil workers, etc. Now, look, I am not saying that the barge is a five-star hotel, and I am aware that one individual with mental health issues sadly took their own life on the barge, and it goes without saying that that is a tragedy. But given the videos that I have just shown you there, and the facilities we know are on offer at that site, and the fact that asylum seekers have, in some cases, better access to many public services than arguably most other people in Britain, do you honestly think now that groups like Care for Calais, Portland Global Friendship, actually think the conditions on that ship are inhumane, or is there a political agenda at play here?